Hey everybody, it's me, Mr. Salchuk. Okay, so this video is going to help you with understanding variables a little bit better and how to find them in a hypothesis or in any of those word problems we've been working on. So I'm going to start off by showing you this is a activity that I've done with my students before, but we are in the COVID time, so it's a little bit different here. You can't exactly do this thing. So, the activity was to determine which building design can withstand a windstorm better and write a hypothesis for the experiment and then create the tower to be tested. So, I had a materials list. The kids would get the materials and they get to build. It was pretty cool. So, now I need to ask myself what kinds of different designs are there for buildings? This activity I know has to do with houses and with designing a house that's able to withstand hurricane force winds. So I'm going to have two different kinds of house designs. Let's do the traditional A-frame as our first type, and then as our second type. Let's try nice old-fashioned. Let's go with a round castle. Yeah, round castle. That sounds pretty easy. Design. Cool. So those are my two designs. Now let's go ahead and see if we can't make a hypothesis with this. So I'm going to go to my hypothesis and I am going to begin my sentence. If a house is built with a castle round design, then it will be able to withstand higher wind speeds than a house that is designed using the traditional A-frame design. Cool. So we have here a hypothesis. Wind speeds is two words, not one. And in our hypothesis, we're going to find a control variable, an independent variable, dependent variable, and a constant variable. So we've already should know that a control variable is the original thing we're testing against. The independent variable is the thing we're changing, the dependent is what we're measuring, and the constant is everything else that's staying the same. So I could rewrite this question slightly different by doing this. Instead of just saying higher wind speeds, what if I gave a specific wind speed? So let's make specific wind speeds. Let's have, instead of it saying higher wind speeds, let's have the round castle design because I'm expecting that to withstand. Underline that. Round castle design will be able to stand. Instead, let's just write in here wind speeds of 75 to 80 miles per hour. And then we know that the A-frame design is going to be our other thing here. And instead, let's have that one say 60 to 65 miles per hour. Now, what I have to do is I have to figure out how exactly to identify which variable is my original and which one is my test or my change. So I've got my control variable as the original thing. In my pre-planning, you got the chance to see the way I was thinking through things. I came up with the traditional A-frame design. That's the design of most houses nowadays, where it's got that cool little triangle roof thing going on, and it's pretty much some square walls. So that's going to be our original. So in this case, that is going to be my control variable. That's the original thing that we were comparing the independent to. So this is our original measure. We can trust that this is what we would count on. So that now is the easy part. Once I figured out what my control variable is, I can identify my independent variable. And my independent variable, and I know that my independent variable is just going to be the opposite thing that was being in the experiment. So I'm going to go ahead and just highlight that, classic red, and copy and paste it. Paste. And that's the round castle outside. Now, what is being measured? Well, we've got higher wind speeds, so the wind speeds are being measured. So I'm going to highlight that one and copy and paste it into the dependent variable. I just realized that I did this in the opposite order from how I normally do it in the presentations. Sorry about that. And then we need to look at everything else that's going to be staying the same. So we would be definitely including same location. We would be including getting blown with wind, or you could just say withstanding winds. I would not say that they're both houses for my example of constant variable. It's just not the best. Okay, hopefully that helps you guys out. Please hit me up with questions if you have questions about this. Remember, this is how to find variables: control, independent, dependent, and constant. Good luck!